Hello, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and a visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's That Celebrity Interview.
Yes, I can.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, good. It's an honor to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
I want my audience to know that Dr. Simon Thomas, she's going to be my PhD for today. She does have a PhD, and she's from the Greater Good Science Center. And she's here to share the habits and the skills to reduce stress and create sustainable happiness at any age. Dr. Thomas, this is a very important subject to me, because I live with a person that does not do stress at all. And he is so serious about that, and he does not. And his life is happier and healthier than mine. I've had to learn. So how can you help my audience avoid some of these things?
Yeah, so thank you, Valder, for that question. What I wanted to share with you was information about LG's Experience Happiness Initiative, which is essentially trying to offer these very skills that you asked about, these sustainable happiness skills, to teens around the country. At the Greater Good Science Center, we were privileged to work to partner with LG Electronics on this campaign. And the idea is that if we all spend a little bit more time cultivating and developing these six sustainable happiness skills, we'll be able to build a foundation of happiness, which inherently makes us more resilient to stress. But at the same time, some of the skills help us manage stress right in the moment.
I want my audience to know those happiness skills have been identified as mindfulness, human connection, positive outlook, purpose, generosity, and gratitude. Let me ask you, because I say just buy an LG refrigerator and a TV like I did, and you're going to be pretty happy. But you've got some ways for people to also find happiness.
Yeah, so what we know from the science of happiness is that our biggest opportunity for leverage for building happiness is in the space of handling stress, building resilience, and fostering more meaningful and benevolent social relationships. It sounds like you have a partner that is a great model for handling stress, but all of us could do a little bit more to strengthen our relationships with others, to make our friends and family and community feel more trusting, a greater sense of kindness and connection with us. One of the easiest skills that I like to offer people in the realm of handling stress and perhaps building happiness at the same time is developing more self-awareness. And that is noticing when you're feeling certain things or having certain thoughts. And one way, in the moment of anxiety or stress, when something is feeling threatening, we can encourage ourselves to take a deep and calming breath. So we breathe in, fill our lungs to capacity, and then slowly breathe out. It's important for the exhale to be slower. This slow exhale actually signals to our body that we're in a place that's safe, that we can be trusting, that we can seek support from others. And again, that's a valuable aspect of building these stronger, more meaningful social connections with others. So kindness, connection, resilience, mindfulness, and then gratitude. There's this robust scientific research on how valuable gratitude can be to our health and well-being and happiness. And all it takes is spending a little bit more time reflecting on the goodness that happens in our lives, and in particular, how other people are contributing to the goodness that we experience day in and day out. And for advanced gratitude practice, we can work on saying thank you more often and more comprehensively to those people who contribute to the goodness in our life. So in all, the LG Experience Happiness Initiative is aiming to offer these scientific insights and practical tips to teens around the country so that they can, again, build this foundation of sustainable happiness for their lifelong.
I'm so glad that you guys and you're a part of this, because, see, I've gone from what I call the dark side, being very what I called tell it like it is, see it like it is, to being all of the things that you have talked about. So I understand the importance of it. But why is this work so important, especially with teens, Doctor?
Yeah, so today what we know from the scientific literature is that teens are extraordinarily stressed. 2 out of 3 teens are experiencing unhealthy levels of stress. And so without the tools to manage and handle and address that stress, or the tools thought from a different perspective to build a foundation of sustainable happiness, which makes you more agile in responding to stress, then teens put themselves at risk of challenges throughout life. So again, what LG's Experience Happiness Platform is aiming to do is get in early and give teens at this formative period in their life the specific skills that they're going to need to cultivate, to develop, to strengthen throughout their lives to maintain this sense of sustainable happiness. So they don't have to go through the dark side and then to the light side and then to the side, which I heard you describe as being authentic. It's very important that authenticity be a part of this route to sustainable happiness. And it sounds like you've discovered some things yourself, but if you want to learn more, you can go to the LGExperienceHappiness.com website, and there is much more detail about the 6 sustainable happiness skills and again, specific lesson plans or exercises or practices or scientific insights that people can use to guide their path towards increased sustainable happiness.
Doctor, I gotta wrap up, but I'd love to know, you do the work, has this changed you?
For me, it's a constant effort. What I do appreciate is that when the more work I do, the better I feel. When I do set aside the time to say thank you to my spouse and really acknowledge what it is that he does to contribute to the goodness in my life, our relationship feels better and I feel better. So like everyone else, it's a constant effort. Like any other skill or activity, we work on it day in and day out. But I can say that when I do it, it definitely makes me feel more stable and content and delighted with my life. So yes, thank you, Valder.
I love that testimony. I want to thank you for being my guest, but I'm going to tell you, and I said this before, and you guys aren't paying me, buy yourself an LG refrigerator and a TV, and you will definitely be happy. Thank you for being my guest, Dr. Emiliana Simon-Thomas. You were a wonderful guest. Thank you very much.
It's my pleasure. Have a nice day, Valder.